Okay. It is a really good thing that I have more canvases coming tomorrow because I'm going to feel horrible about the fact that I am right now getting ready to pour the two canvases that I asked my best friend if he would like to help me pick colors for. And oh my gosh, I had leftovers from my first painting that I did tonight, which is over there. And it turned out really good, and I'm really hoping that it dries as good as it looks right now, which we know never happens. And anyway, I had leftovers from that one, and of course, I wanted to dump them out somewhere like I always do, so I had this pour from yesterday, our lovely glitter glue that I was not impressed with. So, I just did a flip cup with the leftovers from my other, and I was so happy about the way the color scheme turned out. I said, well, we just have to try to replicate this. The problem is my pink. I ran out of the medium magenta, and all I have left is the, is it dark or bright? What do we call this? Quinacridone. That's right. The specific, funky, awesome. Okay, so I've got all of my colors here, and I already have the green in there. If I remember correctly, oh gosh, I'm gonna get paint everywhere because I'm using my dirty. Okay, let's do that first. Get some paper towels ready. Anxiety. Don't really feel like I need these anymore. God knows they move around and mess me up while we're mixing and pouring, and we're just gonna go ahead and put the stir sticks aside. Okay. My other one was pretty much just a base of this. It's a metallic black that I, what color did I put in next? Yellow, I think. Was it pink? We'll do pink first. And I'm just gonna do a flip cup with some torching immediately after. That was what gave me awesome cells in that first one. And we going to try to have enough here for both of these. Cup. Wow. Looks like I don't really have an option here. I'm just gonna have to put a little on all four corners here. Just those two. If I do it like this with a little dribble, like this with a little dribble. All right, I've got some green left, but I don't have any room for it. So, we're going to put a will work as my divider. Here's my torch, and we are centered on. Oh, I hate. There's my feet. There you are. That's a little better. Maybe it's not. Alright. No reason to play with it too much. Anxiety, nut crack. And here we go. Just let you go like that and get you going. Get the rest of my cells popping up here. This is honestly not even turning out close to the way the other one looked, which is always the way this goes, isn't it? Okay, now, before things get too crazy here, I almost feel like I don't have enough paint for this one over here. Gosh, could you be in a worse spot? Okay. Darn it. That actually has quite a bit of the corner. Still needs. There. got a bit messy on that one. Now these are the things that make you wonder, because I'm not really getting very much cell action on here, but look at the cells that popped up on this. I gotta do something with that edge. Funny. That's what my cup looks like. Cup is gorgeous. Where are my cells here, people? Well, you know, we just don't always get what we want when we pour. That's just the truth. And sometimes we have to be okay with that. And I hate it. But it's the truth. So in the meantime, I will just fix my edges. I should turn off the video so you guys don't have to continue to watch me do this. As soon as I finish up that side, it'll look much better like these do. And we've got some cell action. And they definitely turned out a little different than I thought they would. They'll be really pretty when they dry because the copper and then the black has gold. It's my black gold color that I've been mixing up that I love. It's actually mostly gold with just like one squirt of black in it. And this is actually, you know, if you look at it, it is creating some nice cells, actually. That's crazy. That's with no silicone. Well, maybe they are going to be alright. I would really like this area to, develop a little more, but we'll see what happens as it dries. Okay, bye guys.